come. I confess, bowing here, I find my rest.
Hello, welcome to Living Faith's Midweek Devotions. We're continuing in our investigative journey of Luke, of the investigative journey of Jesus. And we're in chapter 14 of Luke. And we've been, for the last few weeks, talking about the hard teachings of Jesus. Last week, we talked about how we are invited to be at the table, the wedding banquet with Jesus in heaven. But a lot of people wanted to reject that invitation. We've got this special invitation to give. And then Jesus takes it up a notch today. As we go further into these hard teachings, what it truly means to be a disciple, the cost of being a disciple. We're at verse 25 in Luke chapter 14. Large crowds were traveling with Jesus, and turning to them, he said, "If anyone comes to me and does not hate father, mother, wife and children, brothers and sisters, yes, even their own lives, such a person cannot be my disciple. And whoever does not carry their cross and follow me cannot be my disciple." Let's pause there for a moment. Jesus uses the word hate when he's talking about father and mother, wife and children, brothers and sisters, yes, even yourself. Well, we also know in Scripture that Jesus says to honor your father and mother, to love and obey them. He also says to submit and respect and honor your spouse, to care for your children, to train them up. And that's all part of love. So we also know that he's not truly saying the big word hate. So what's he saying here? Well, he's talking about being a disciple for him. So what he's saying here is, do not love them more than me. Do not serve them more than me. So if you put more love towards your father and mother, more love towards your spouse, more love towards your children or even yourself than you do to Jesus and to God, then rather than loving him, you're loving them and you're hating him. To follow Jesus, to be a believer of him, it means to put everything else aside, all your relationships aside, even your own self aside, and put him first. That's the first cost, the primary cost of being a disciple. That's what it is to carry your cross. It's going to look different. It's going to take some sacrifices. People in this world are going to say, put yourself first, and then put your spouse and your family next. They're usually not going to say, put God first. And that's why it's carrying your cross, because you're going to stand out differently. It's going to be a harder journey to do this as a disciple. He continues in verse 28. Suppose one of you wants to build a tower. Won't you first sit down and estimate the cost to see if you have enough money to complete it? For if you lay the foundation and are not able to finish it, everyone who sees it will ridicule you, saying, this person began to build and wasn't able to finish. Or suppose a king is about to go to war against another king. Won't he first sit down and consider whether he is able with 10,000 men to oppose the one coming against him with 20,000? If he is not able, he will send a delegation while the other is still a long way off and will ask for terms of peace. In the same way, those of you who do not give up everything you have cannot be my disciples. So now Jesus goes on and furthers that cost of being a disciple. It's not just about him being the primary relationship that you have in your life. But now, it's him being on top of everything. All your material possessions, all the things that you invest in, he needs to be the primary investment. He needs to be the primary focus. And so to be a disciple of Jesus, we need to estimate that cost, what that will cost. It means not looking like others in this world, not always having the best things or the most things or the newest things. It might mean that we need to sacrifice that to put him first. It means the priority of our schedules and the time that we put for Him might be putting aside what we prefer. Maybe not going to that football game on Sunday so that you can go to church and be with your church family. It might mean not being able to sleep in so that you can make it to that early morning Bible study during the week, or on Sunday mornings before church. It might mean not going to see that movie that all your friends want to go see because it supports an agenda or that you don't like, or it has many terrible words or sexual scenes that you as a Christian just do not want to support because you follow Jesus. You don't want your mind to wander into those things. You need it to stay focused on Him. The cost of being a disciple for Jesus means that you need to stand out, and that's why he goes into the following last verses. He says, "Salt is good, but if it loses its saltiness, how can it be made salty again? It is fit neither for the soil nor for the manure pile. It is thrown out. Whoever has ears to hear, let them hear." Jesus also in Scripture calls us the salt of the earth. And so when he says, if salt loses its saltiness, he's saying, dear Christian, dear follower, dear believer of Jesus, do not lose your saltiness. You are the salt of the earth. You are the one to stand out. You are the one that gives flavor. Flavor to this world. Flavor of Jesus. Flavor of what he's done for us. He is the only way to save. Preservation is also what salt does. And so Jesus has, as his followers, he has instilled in us this preservation of his church, this preservation of his word, this preservation of spreading the good news so that others will be saved too, preserved for eternity. Your friends, the cost of being a disciple is high. It's the most expensive thing. But really, the cost of not being one of his disciples is detrimental eternally. So we get this privilege, dear friends, of being his disciples, of investing our time, our priority and relationships, everything for Jesus. We do this because he invested his own life, his own self to save us. His priority was always us. His priority was to save us and to love us so that we get to sit at the table with him at the wedding banquet of the Lamb forever. Dear friends, may that encourage you this week. And I pray that we see you next week. God bless you. Lord, I need